Hello everyone, I'm Lee Shinan, a lecturer at Huawei. In the previous chapter, we discussed some security threats WLAN faces and some defensive measures we can use. Now let's start with the content of Lesson 6. We will explain in detail the knowledge related to WLAN access security. First, let's look at the WLAN access process. For us users, typically when we use Wi-Fi at home, all our phones need to do is detect the Wi-Fi signal and then enter the password. This allows us to connect, but in reality, through the eyes of an engineer, this process is more complex than just entering a password. It's more complicated in implementation. From discovering the Wi-Fi signal to finally accessing the Wi-Fi, there are many steps involved. For instance, there's link authentication, user association, and access authentication. After these three steps, we can finally access the network. For link authentication, these two involve our terminal sending an authentication request, and then the AP replying with an authentication response. Once the authentication request is approved, we proceed to user association. After successful user association, we begin access authentication. This is the entire WLAN access process. So here we will talk about link authentication and access authentication. We will explain these in detail shortly. First, let's discuss link authentication. There are two types of link authentication. One is open system authentication. The other is shared key authentication. Let's first look at open system authentication. This so-called open system is actually completely open. As long as you attempt to authenticate, I will let you pass. It can be said that open system authentication is essentially unprotected. So, if a certain SSID has no password, you can connect to it directly. This is a typical example of open system authentication. Of course, this type of authentication is usually not used because it lowers the security of our devices. But this open system authentication can be combined with other types of access authentication for use. We will mention this later in our study. That's the first type of link authentication, open system authentication. Now let's look at the next type, shared key authentication. This authentication method is very typical. This authentication method involves a designed password. Our user terminals and AP must be pre-configured with the same key. Then, during authentication, our AP sends a challenge, and our STA, station, responds with an answer. Then, our AP calculates the response, and if it finds that the keys match, the authentication is successful. Thus, the link authentication between the STA and the AP is completed. These are the two methods of link authentication. Now let's look at an overview diagram of our entire access security. In this diagram, we can see within this box, we performed scanning, link authentication, and association processes. This is the link authentication we just discussed. In the diagram below, we have another access authentication. This access authentication is also very important. Let's look at it together. First, we've already talked about the two link authentications. Now let's look at access authentication. This access authentication involves different access security policies. Regarding these security policies, we have three types, Open WEP and WPA/WPA2. So if you see these three types, you might find them familiar. Why is that? Because when we configure our home routers, if we have not dealt with commercial WLAN equipment and we have configured home routers within the router, we can configure our access authentication security policies. So we have three types, Open, WEP, and WPA/WPA2. Let's look at what this so-called policy means. For example, the open policy within this open strategy, we have link authentication, access authentication, and data encryption. That is to say, this access authentication security policy is not just about access authentication, it's a set of strategies. Within this policy, we have different link authentications and access authentications. So this access authentication corresponds to here is a part of the policy. So let's see, if the security policy is open, our link authentication uses open system authentication, then no access authentication is required and the data is not encrypted. Regarding this security strategy, it can be said that the security level is quite low. Our data is not encrypted, nor do we require authentication. Therefore, anyone connecting to the Wi-Fi will have their data unencrypted. Theoretically, we could intercept and see what kind of data you are transmitting over the network. This is not secure. Generally, in home settings, we rarely use this type. Moving on to the second strategy, WEP, this strategy utilizes shared key link authentication followed by data encryption. That is, with WEP authentication, our data is encrypted. Even if someone intercepts our data, they can't understand it because it is encrypted. Of course, if there's a way to crack it, that's a different story. And the third type, WPA/WPA2, is the most commonly applied and widely used security strategy. Let's look at this strategy. This strategy's link authentication still uses open system authentication, still employs open system authentication. That is, if you send an authentication request, I will respond with an authentication reply. Anyone can connect. But in access authentication here, we have different settings: PSK, PPSK, or 802.1x. This type of access authentication ensures our security. It's not enough just to pass link authentication to connect. You also need to pass access authentication. Here, we can also configure the method of key negotiation, PTK or GTK. For data encryption, we use GKIP and CCMP. That means under WPA/WPA2 mode, our transmitted data is also encrypted, and the encryption strength is higher than RC4, therefore offering higher security. Now, let's take a detailed look at the security strategy WEP. Why not take a detailed look at the security strategy OPEN? Because OPEN has no protective measures, so it doesn't need much examination. Let's start with WEP. WEP uses the RC4 algorithm, then encrypts with a static key. That is, under the same SSID, all STAs use the same key. In our wireless network, there's a drawback here. Our WEP keys are exchanged in plain text. This means when we send the key, it could potentially be intercepted. Someone could find out what your key is. Thus, this is not sufficiently secure. We do not recommend its use. So in WEP, we use a shared key method during link authentication. Here there is a challenge, then an encrypted challenge. This means our AP sends a challenge, and our STA encrypts this challenge with its key. The AP also encrypts the challenge with its own key. Then the two encrypted forms are compared. If they match, the AP knows that your key matches its key. You then pass. This is the security strategy of WEP. Let's look now at the most widely used today, WPA and WPA2 security strategies. Let's examine further the widely used WPA and WPA2 security strategies. These strategies are divided into two types, personal and enterprise versions. Large enterprises typically use the enterprise version. The enterprise version has higher cost requirements, while the personal version is less costly. Our home routers use this personal version. Let's look at the differences between the personal and enterprise versions. First, a dedicated authentication server, which is not present in the personal version, just like the Wi-Fi we use at home, right? We just need a router. It's not feasible to buy an authentication server. That's just not possible. But in the enterprise version, we do have what's called a RADIUS server. That's the authentication server. Usernames, passwords are specifically sent to the authentication server. It checks if the user is legitimate. Whereas for the personal version, we use a pre-shared key. As long as the key matches, the client can access the network. And we know that here, the key is a pre-shared key, used solely for authentication, not for encryption. So the encryption method we use with WPA is more secure than WEP. This is the security strategy of WPA2. Here, in the authentication process of WPA and WPA2, we have two modes, PSK and PPSK. We just mentioned the pre-shared key, which is the PSK pre-shared key. This is the pre-shared key. So if we need authentication here, we need to configure the same pre-shared password on both the client and the device, which is the pre-shared key. This is the password we usually set up on Wi-Fi. But because in a home network, we can't assign a separate password to every device, so this form still carries some risks. If we want higher security, we can use PPSK, private PSK. The biggest difference between the two is that in PPSK, each user can have an individual password. You have one, I have one. This way, passwords are not shared, and security is further enhanced. Moreover, we will know which user because only you know your own password. So once you go online, for instance, if you do something undesirable, then we can know who logged in with that permission. This is PPSK, which is more secure than PSK, because every user has a different password. That concludes Section 6, the content about WLAN Access Security. Next, let's look at WLAN Data Security.